girls, we're going to sing a wee song called Jesus Loves Me, probably the most famous of all Christian songs for children. And then we're going to show you a video about storing wheat for winter, because in the summertime it's lovely and warm, but the winter time it gets cold and we need to light our fires or put on our heating systems. And some parts of the world, they don't have heating systems or gas or oil. They rely on a little wooden fire, so they need to store their wheat for the winter. So we're going to go into this shed and learn something about the wheat in the winter. Jesus loves me, this I know. How do we know? For the Bible tells me so.
Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong.
Everybody? Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Let's go and learn about the word in the shed and why it's there. Here we go.
G'day boys and girls, it's Colin here. I'm out for a walk, and a place where I love to go to in Poland is the Polish mountains. And quite often whenever you travel through the Polish mountains, you'll come across little mountain houses just like this here, little cottages, and they're also known as shepherd's cottages, because the shepherd would look after the sheep all over the mountainside, and he would have a wee house. And of course the wee house is a place of shelter for him, because Poland or lots of European countries can get lots of snow in the winter time. Therefore he needs to be inside for shelter, for warmth. He can light the fire and keep warm, and he's able to look after sheep to protect them from bears and wild cats and lions and dogs and wolves and all sorts of wild animals, maybe thieves. So he needs to be where the sheep are, but he just can't sleep under the stars. In the summertime, yes, he can and he does do that, but in the winter time he needs to be into a little mountain cottage, a little mountain house. I often say to Joanne, it's one place I would love to go for a little holiday, is just sleep in a mountain house in Poland, in the Polish mountains. Very simple little cottage made of wood. No facilities, you're not getting any running water, nothing. It's just this place of shelter with literally a roof over your head. But something inside this here I want to talk about, as I've noticed. We're going to have a wee look inside to see what we find. You see the little cottage, very simple. But outside, you notice inside there's lots and lots of chopped wood. And I thought, when I see chopped wood, there's something about chopped wood I really like, because chopped wood is for fire. And I love a fire, whether it's a campfire or a fire in the living room in the winter time, because fire gives lots of warmth, it gives heat. And I thought about chopping sticks. When I was a wee boy, that's the only thing we had to heat our home, was an open fire. And of course, during the summer, you used to have to gather sticks. My dad would saw down trees, put them into rings with a chainsaw, and then we'd have to chop them up with a hatchet or an axe into little bits, and then you'd have to store them either in a shed or put them, quite often people put them in the side of their house. You can see this little house made of thatch. Of course, it's to make it waterproof. And there's lots of Bible stories. Every time I seem to see something, I try to think, is there a Bible story I can relate to? And whenever I think of this here, in the days of Elisha, in the Book of Kings in the Bible. There was lots of young men were cutting down trees. They were making a college to study in, and one of them was busy, so excited cutting down, that his axe flew off the shaft. The axe bit, the metal bit, flew off into the River Jordan. And Elisha said, "Where did you land? Where did it go to?" Because he was really worried and panicking, saying, "I borrowed the axe. It's now in the river. I can't find it, and I don't have money to pay it back." And Elisha was able to do a miracle. He put a branch into the river and it floated, and he said, "Take it back," and he was able to continue his work of building what they were building. But inside here, I see evidence of wood that has been cut down. There was once strong trees cut down, and now it's been stored for the winter. In other words, the people here have made preparation. And the Bible often talks about preparation. For example, in Amos chapter 4, verse 12, it says, "Prepare to meet thy God," or "Prepare to meet your God." And that reminds me, as I go through life, that one day the Lord Jesus Christ will come back again, and every one of us will stand before him and give account of our lives, if we're Christians, give account of our service, what we've done for God, and if we're not a Christian, give account of why we're not a Christian. And of course, the Lord Jesus then will say, "Stand aside, I don't know you." But whenever it talks about preparation, that's why we go to school. We go to school to prepare for later years in life. We go to get an education, we do exams, so whenever we get a job, we are trained for that. If you don't do well at school, if you don't learn to read, or you can't write, or you can't count, then it's going to be really difficult for you to get a job. If you can't read, you can't pass your driving test. If you can't count, then you're not going to be very good with money. So if you can't read and you can't count and you can't talk, for example, learn how to pronounce your words, it's really difficult to talk on the telephone or to write a message or anything like that. So going to school is absolutely vital, not just to get an education, but to be able to do well in life. And especially whenever I think as a Christian, one of the great books we have as a Christian is the Bible. And the Bible teaches us all about God, not just about about God in heaven, about the life of Jesus Christ on earth, but it teaches me how to live my life, the difference between right and wrong and good and evil. And the Bible never goes out of date. It's never outdated. It's always relevant. Lots of things come and go. Today, lots of homes, modern day houses today, for example, don't have an open fire. You can't burn wood in a fire because you don't have one. It's either gas or electricity. But olden times, whenever people built a house, for example, in my house where I grew up, there was, I think, 5 fireplaces. Every bedroom and the living room had a fire because the winter time was so cold. The only way you could heat your house was no electricity, no central heating, no gas, no oil, and the rooms would have been really cold. So you could have 5 fires going at once. Therefore, in the summertime, quite a lot of time and effort was made in the summertime preparing for the winter. And the Bible talks about summer, it talks about autumn, it talks about spring, it talks about winter, the seasons of the year. And it talks about the summertime is a time for farmers to make preparation, to make their hay, they make their silage, they bring their crops in. So in the winter time, when the animals are in, they've got food to feed their animals. And that's why whenever the mountain man cuts down the trees in the winter time, he doesn't have to worry about being cold. He's enough firewood to keep him going all winter long until the spring time comes. So he makes preparation. Therefore, and it's so important when you're in school to make preparation for high school to make preparation for your career, for a job, for working. But while this is so important and so many children make a big effort, which is really good in your school days, but it's so much more important to make preparation for the life after or the hereafter. And for me, it's making preparation for heaven, to be with God forever. But the wonderful thing is, Jesus has already made that preparation, because whenever he went to the cross and laid down his life, he died to take away all our sin. So all we have to do is tell God we're sorry for that sin. It's called repentance. And whenever we ask God, tell him we're sorry for our sin, he gives us a clean heart and he makes us ready for heaven. So he has prepared the way. That's why when John the Baptist, he was Jesus' best friend, he was a wee baby born just before Jesus. And the Bible says whenever he was born, his job was to tell everyone, "Here comes Jesus." And whenever he saw Jesus coming, at 30 years of age, Jesus was, "Here comes Jesus." He says, "Look, here comes Jesus. Look unto Jesus, the one who will take away the sin of the world." And he said, "Look, He has come to take away the sin of the world. He's come to make preparation for everyone to be with God and to meet God. And I thought, what a wonderful challenge that was. Way back then, John the Baptist was telling everyone, look, behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. So whenever you see firewood stored up, it means that people have made preparation for a cold winter and they don't need to worry whatsoever about being cold. And I thought, the best time to make preparation is early summer. So you have to, some people leave it until it's too late and end up in really cold in the winter time. So the best time, the Bible says, is early in the morning is the best time to talk to God, to read your Bible, and of course the best time to seek God and to become a Christian is early in your life at primary school. So whenever you're young, you can live your life for God and pleasing to God. He can help you with school, with your reading and your writing and all these things. This is my wee cottage here, and I would love to go to sleep, but there's no bed in this one here. So I'm just going to have to keep walking until I find another one with a wee bed, and I'm able to go for a wee sleep. But if it's cold tonight, I don't have to worry, because I've put the firewood to keep myself warm. Have a good day. See you next time.
Really enjoyed that one, but the wood reminds me, as a little boy, we used to go in the fields and collect sticks, and my dad would cut down trees, put them into rings, and of course you'd get the hatchet or the axe and put them into pieces and store the wood in the winter, in the summertime for the winter. And my mum would often say, go and fill the wheelbarrow with sticks, fill the stick box, bring sticks into the fire. And so you go to the shed, put them in a wheelbarrow, bring them over and fill up put them beside the fire so it's used in the winter time in the cold, long, dark evenings. Let's sing Jesus Loves the Little Children. Song, Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world, red and yellow, black and white, all are precious in his sight. That's all for today. Really enjoyed today's story about chopping wood, storing wood for the winter. We'll see you next time.